Good morning, children. In the previous class, we have done up to 16th sum in workbook. Today, let us do the 17th sum in page number 66 workbook. Okay, children, let us do the 17th sum in page number 66 workbook. Now, I am reading the 17th question. A vehicle travels 27 kilometers in 81 minutes. How much time will it take to cover 207 kilometers if the vehicle travels with the constant speed? Here it is given that the vehicle travels 27 kilometers in 81 minutes. First we have to find out how many kilometers does the vehicle travels in 1 minute. Then we have to find out how much time does it require to travel 207 kilometers. For finding out the distance traveled in 1 minute, we have to use the operation division. And for finding out the distance traveled in For finding out the time required to travel 207 kilometers, we have to use the operation multiplication. Okay, children. Now let us do the sum. Time taken to travel 27 kilometers. So the time taken to travel 27 kilometers is 81 minutes. Now we have to find out Time taken to travel 1 kilometer. So for that you have to use the operation division. You have to divide 81 with 27. So here it is given that the vehicle takes 81 minutes to travel 27 kilometers. Now we have to find out how much time does it take to travel 1 kilometer. For that we have to use the operation division. Let us divide 81 with 27. 27 threes are 81. So it takes 3 minutes to travel 1 kilometer. It takes 3 minutes to travel 1 kilometer. Now we have to find out the time taken to travel 207 kilometers. For that you have to use the operation multiplication. Time taken to travel 1 kilometer is 3 minutes. Time taken to travel 1 kilometer is 3 minutes. Time taken to travel 207 kilometers is equals to 207 into 3. Now let us multiply 207 with 3. 3 7s are 21. 3 0s are 0. 2. 0 plus 2, 2. 3 2s are 6. So it takes 621 minutes to travel 207 kilometers. It takes 621 minutes to travel 207 kilometers. Did you understand, children? Here it is given that the vehicle takes 81 minutes to travel 27 kilometers. Now we have to find out how many minutes does the vehicle take to travel 207 kilometers. For that, first we have to use the operation division to find out how much time it takes to travel 1 kilometer. So it takes 3 minutes to travel 1 kilometer. After that, we have to find out how much time is taken by the vehicle to travel 207 kilometers. For that, we have to use the operation multiplication. We have to multiply 207 with 3 and we will get 621 minutes. So, it takes 621 minutes to travel 207 kilometers. Okay, children. Now, let us do the 18th sum. Let us do the 18th sum. Now let us do the 18th sum. So now I am reading the 18th question. It takes 9 liters of paint to color 3 walls. How much paint will be required to paint 7 such walls? So 9 liters of paint is required to paint 3 walls. So we have to find out how many liters of paint is required to 7 walls. First we have to find out how many liters of paint is required to paint 1 wall, and then we have to find out how many liters of paint is required to paint 7 walls. For finding the Pain required for one ball, we have to use the operation division. And for finding out the pain required to paint 7 balls, we have to use the operation multiplication. Okay, children. So let us do the sum. Quantity of paint required. Quantity of paint required to paint 3 walls is equals to 9 liters. 9 liters of paint is required to paint 3 walls. Now let us find out quantity of paint required. Quantity of paint required to paint 1 wall. For that we have to use the operation division. So 9 divided by 3. So 9 divided by 3 is 3 liters. So to paint 1 wall, it requires 3 liters of paint. Now let us find out the quantity of paint required to paint 7 walls. So quantity of paint required for 1 wall. Quantity of paint required to paint 1 wall is equals to 3 liters. Okay, children. Quantity of paint required to paint 9 walls is equals to 7 walls. Quantity of paint required to paint 7 walls is equals to 3 into 7. 3 into 7 is equal to 21 liters. So to paint 7 walls, it requires 21 liters of paint. Okay, children, 21 liters of paint. Did you understand, children? Okay. Now let us do the 19th sum. Okay, children, let us do the 19th sum. Now I am reading the 19th question. A train takes 6 hours to cover 1086 kilometers. How much distance will it cover in 14 hours? So a train covers 1086 kilometers in 6 hours. First we have to find out how much distance does the train covers in 1 hour. And then we have to find out how much distance does it cover in 14 hours. Okay, children, first we have to find out how much distance does the train covers in 1 hour, and then we have to find out how much distance does the train cover in 14 hours. Okay, children, let us do the sum. Distance covered by train in 1 hour. Distance covered by train in 1 hour is 1086. Okay, children, now let us find out the distance covered in by the train in 1 hour. For that we have to use the operation division. So let us divide 1086 by 6. 1086 divided by 6. 6 ones are 6. 10 minus 6 is 4. Bring down 8. 6 8s are 48. 48 minus 48 is 0. Bring down 6. 6 ones are 6. 6 minus 6 is 0. So the train covers 181 kilometers in 1 hour. 181 kilometers in 1 hour. Now we have to find out how much distance does it covers in 14 hours. So let us find out the distance covered by the train in 14 hours. Distance covered by train in 1 hour. So distance covered by train in 1 hour is equal to 181 kilometers. Now let us find out the distance covered by train in 14 hours. 14 hours. Let us multiply 181 with 14. Okay, children. 4 1 4, 4 8 32, 4 1 4, 7. Okay, children. Now 1 is in tens place, so put 0 in ones place. So 1 1s are 1, 1 8s are 8, 1 1s are 1. Okay, children. 4 3 15 2. So the train covers 2,534 kilometers in 14 hours. The train covers 2,534 kilometers in 14 hours. Okay, children. Now let us do the 20th sum. Okay, children. Now let us do the 20th sum. Reading the 20th question. According to the amount paid by Mrs. Sharma last month, find the cost she need to pay this month for the given quantity of items. According to the amount paid by Mrs. Sharma last month, find the cost she need to pay this month for the given items. Okay, children. Here some items are given. Now we have to find out how much amount Mrs. Sharma has to pay for the items. Okay, children. So the rates for the last month are given. Now we have to find out how much amount does she pay for this month. From the prices given in the last month, we have to find out the amount she has to pay for this month. So 75 for 3 kg pulses. She is paying rupees 75 for 3 kg pulses. Now we have to find out how much amount she has to pay for 5 kg pulses. So 5 kg pulses will cost. 5 kg pulses will cost. In the last month she paid 75 rupees for 3 kg pulses. Now we have to find out how much amount she has to pay for 5 kg pulses for this month. So the cost of 1 kg of pulses is bought by division. So the cost of 1 kg of pulses is bought by division. So let us divide 75 with 3. 3 goes in 7. 3 goes in 7 2 times. 3 goes in 15 5 times. So the cost of 1 kg of pulses in the last month is 25 rupees. So the cost of 5 kg of pulses for this month is, we have to multiply 25 with 5. We have to multiply 25 with 5. 5 5s are 25. 5 2s are 10. 10 plus 2, 12. So she has to pay rupees 125 per 5 kg of pulse. Okay, children. Now let us do the next one, which is rupees 48 per 4 packets of bread. So she had paid 48 rupees for 4 packets of bread. Now we have to find out how much she has to pay for 6 packets of bread. Last month she purchased 4 packets of bread, but this month she purchased 6 packets of bread. For last month 4 packets of bread cost 48 rupees. Now we have to find out the cost of 6 packets. First let us find out the cost of 1 packet. For that we have to divide 48 with 4. 4 ones are 4, bring down 8, 4 twos are 8. So the cost of 1 packet is 12 rupees. Now we have to find out the cost of 6 packets. So 12 into 6. 6 twos are 12, 6 ones are 6 plus 7. So the cost of 6 packets of bread is 72 rupees. Okay children. Now let us do the next question. Last one, Mrs. Sharma bought 4 packets of milk for 60 rupees. She bought 4 packets of milk for 60 rupees. 4 packets of milk. But this month she bought 8 packets of milk. So we have to find out the cost of 8 packets of milk. For finding the cost of 8 packets of milk, first we have to find out the cost of 1 packet of milk. So let us divide 60 with 4. 4 ones are 4. 4 fives are 20. So the cost of 1 packet of milk is 15 rupees. Now we have to find out the cost of 8 packets of milk. Okay children, 8 packets of milk cost, 8 packets of milk cost is equal to, we have to divide, sorry, we have to multiply 15 with 8, we have to multiply 15 with 8, 8 5s are 40, 8 1s are 8 plus 4, 12, so it is 120 rupees. So the cost of 8 packets of milk is 120 rupees. Okay children, this is also unitary method. First we have find out the cost of one item and then we have find out the cost of required number of items. Okay children, now let us do the 21st sum. Okay children, let us do the 21st sum. Let us do the 21st sum. Okay children. According to the amount paid by, sorry children, I am again reading the 20th sum. Let me read the 21st question. 154 grams of butter gets used in 14 cakes. How much butter will be required to make 11 such cakes? So 154 grams of butter is used in 14 cakes. Now we have to find out how much butter will be used for making 11 cakes. So first we have to find out how much butter is required to make 1 cake. And then we have to find out how much butter is used for making 11 cakes. First you have to use the operation division. And then you have to use the operation multiplication. Quantity of butter used for 14 cakes. Quantity of butter used for 14 cakes is 154 grams. Now we have to find out quantity of butter used for 1 cake. For that you have to use the operation division. So 154 divided by 14. So 154 divided by 14. 14 ones are 14. 1 bring down 4. 14 ones are 14. So 11 grams of butter is used for making 14 kgs. Sorry, 11 grams of butter is used for making 1 cake. Now we have to find out how much grams of butter is used for making 11 cakes. 1 cup of butter used for 1 cake is equal to 11 grams. Now we have to find out quantity of butter used for 11 cakes. For that we have to use the operation multiplication. So 11 into 11. 11 11s are 121. So 121 grams of butter is used for making 11 cakes. Okay children, 121 grams of butter is used for making 11 cakes. Okay children, now I have done up to 21st sum. All of you do the 22nd sum for homework. Okay children, all of you do the 22nd sum for homework. That's all for today's class. Okay, bye.